BoJack Horseman. And the first season of that show, I wrote the 11th episode, which was called Downer Ending. And Downer Ending is an episode where BoJack Horseman goes on a drug trip and a way to procrastinate from writing his novel. And in that drug trip, he experiences an alternate reality in which he could have lived in Maine with a woman he loved and had a child, had a very simple a life close to nature. And we started thinking about, like, well, this is such a fun episode that's playing with reality. What if we created a show that was about this, about kind of the philosophy around reality and how we experience it and how we might experience it?
I'll go. Oh, so considering the people that you're working with in this project, and but the narrative of what this show is actually about, how much humor could we actually be expecting in this?
I would say that hopefully you laugh at least once an episode.
Okay.
it's definitely more of a drama than it is a comedy.
Okay. Okay.
But it's also meant to be kind of a introspective yet fun exploration of what is possible.
Yes. Yes. Okay. Yeah. Considering you have worked on Mad TV, you've obviously worked on Lego movies, and Rosa just being who Rosa is, I would just suspect.
Yeah.
You know, like humor.
Right. Yeah, no, I have a very strange resume that I started on Cold Case,
yeah,
which is an hour-long drama. But all of those different shows have kind of informed the makeup of the show, which is interesting, to do murder mystery, sketch, family. Yeah.
So time is always so fickle, and it can work against us or it can be a great asset. So how does Alma's newfound relationship with time work for and against her in this series?
Interesting. Well, I think her new relationship with time, especially at first, is very difficult for her because she's trying to navigate what this is, what it means, how she moves through it, if she has any control over it or not. And then as she develops her abilities, she's able to begin to use it to her benefit, and ultimately does.
Will we
find this is the director's name, but how do you communicate your vision to the director? Sort of that kind of process, because the words are so great and the visuals are so great. How do you guys kind of collaborate together? Is there
Yeah, what's interesting is that our director, Hisko Kjulsing, is in Amsterdam, and he comes out for the live action shoots, and then we also met early on and sat with him and talked about the show, and then he would just draw up images while we were there, and we would like discuss the images and give him feedback. I also make a lot of Pinterest pages, so I'll just get tons of photo references for locations, cars, characters, wardrobe. And that definitely helps too, just in terms of thinking about like the style or the artwork or the props. And he's super collaborative. Occasionally there are like funny things that are difficult because they don't have Halloween in Amsterdam, so you're like, we don't need 5 jack-o'-lanterns on the roof of a house. That doesn't exactly happen. You know, there's some communication, like, or the license plate in the States is more of a square than a long rectangle. But they're incredibly easy to work with, very minimal, very supportive.
Well, question. My father actually has a cochlear implant. What inspired you to give Alma a cochlear implant?
So in college and in high school, I studied ASL and then did a deaf culture and history class. And there's on campus, there's a house that's just for deaf community. And I was really taken by deaf culture, just how like beautiful and loving and open and expressive it is. And I also became aware of the kind of the push-pull of attention around the cochlear implant in the deaf community. And we really want Alma to be pulled in different directions in different worlds. Not only like, is this really happening or is this not really happening, but also she's in the hearing world, that she's also part of a deaf world, that she's part of the Mexican-American experience, but she also has this Jewish heritage. And that searching for identity of where I fit, and the idea of when you don't quite fit in any one place, how you experience life.
Yeah, I thought that was very interesting.
Oh, good. Yeah.
Is there something in Alma that makes her special, like something physical in her mind, or
okay.
Is it what makes her so special? Do we find out about that?
Yeah, that's something that we explore and debate in the series. I don't know that we ever answer it or will answer it.
Don't ever answer it.
But I mean, the intention of the show is that different audience members can watch it and have a different experience. So they can watch and say, this is definitely A Beautiful Mind, or they can watch it and they can say, this is definitely The Matrix. This is definitely happening, or this is definitely not happening. But we're playing with this idea of reality and perceptions of reality and the fact that there may not be any ultimate truth, that we all bring our own perceptions to every situation, and that maybe the ultimate truth is kind of like the lively interactions of all those perceptions, that none of us hold it. It exists outside of us.
Interesting.
So I would say that this has been a really exciting year at Comic-Con for Amazon Studios. And I want to know, how does it feel to be part of another spectacle that Amazon is presenting?
Fantastic. I mean, Amazon has been amazing to work with. They've been so supportive. This is their first adult animated show, and they're 100% behind it, which feels great. The marketing has been tremendous. They really understand the show, and they know how to promote it. They know how to message it. The executives have been so loving, so kind, so involved. I mean, I joke that it feels like I'm going to work to like a French pastry shop, and I'm a croissant, and they're like folding me and buttering me with a little brush. But it feels so like delicate and special and considered.
It just seems like everybody's trying to put together like a superhero show or a show with somebody with special abilities, but this one just feels so unique, like a breath of fresh air and something that's been done again. Seems like you really put a new twist on it. You know what I mean? Make it new and interesting to fans and engage it.
Well, thank you. Yeah, we're trying to make it as real and grounded and as authentic as possible. So hopefully it feels that way.
Will Alma have a love interest in the film or no?
Well, she has a boyfriend, okay. Sam. And so a lot of the first season is their relationship. And he's a wonderful character. I think you'll really enjoy him.
But he has no abilities or anything special about him.
He's a pretty sweet, grounded, regular guy.
Just a regular guy.
Yeah. Yeah.
That'll be good to see the interaction.
Yeah.
Well, I think that's the time, so thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah.